Former President Bill CLlNTON setting off a new controversy with this answer to a question about former Senator Al Franken, who resigned following sexual harassment allegations.
I think the norms have really changed in terms of what you can do to somebody against their will, how much you can crowd their space, make them miserable at work. You don't have to physically assault somebody to make them, uncomfortable at work or in, at home or in their utter just walking around. That, I think, is good.
So let's bring in Alanny Davis. He's a former White House special counsel for President CLlNTON, who is the author of The Unmaking of the President 2016, How FBI Director James Comey Cost Hillary CLlNTON the Presidency. Also with me, CNN political commentators Angela Rye and Alice Stewart. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, Don.
So, Ms. Rye, it has never been okay to do something to someone against their will, and that's a fact. But what did Bill, what do you think of his comments?
I think he was stumbling. Don, I think the reality of it is the rules have changed, and that is a good thing. I think that it would have been great for Bill CLlNTON to be able to pull that sentence off succinctly, and he just didn't nail it. And I think the challenge is, given his history, people are looking for him to say the wrong thing here, and frankly, this was not the right thing. As a father of a daughter, as a grandfather of a granddaughter, he just has to do better, and he has to quickly. He does not have the luxury of Donald Trump to misspeak with great regularity. He has to be precise and right on point, and he wasn't.
Okay, here's what a spokesperson for Bill CLlNTON said, Alanny. He said, it is clear from the context he was not suggesting that there was ever a time that it was acceptable to do something against someone's will. He's saying that norms have changed in a variety of ways in how we interact with each other, with one another, and that's all for the good. So is this a word choice problem, or is there more to it? What do you think of that statement?
No, for sure it's a word choice problem. I agree with the former commenter. He was asked about Senator Franken. There was a process issue. He's very close with Senator Franken, who immediately resigned. I do think he never would support anybody being forced to do something against their will, and I do agree that the words chosen weren't the best choices. But I think that that's exactly what he meant. He would never support somebody at any time in our history. Norms have never changed about doing something against people's will.
Did it sound like he was implying, though, that Senator Franken's accuser was doing something wrong? Did any of you get that?
No.
No?
If you're asking me, I think 27 women on Saturday Night Live attested on that particular program to Senator Franken being a good person and never showing those indications. Other women disagreed. I just think that President CLlNTON got caught up in the wrong context and misspoke.
All right,
as
Alice,
the
I'm...
earlier speaker said.
All right, Alice, let me hear from you.
Donna, I think to Angela's point, I think Bill CLlNTON just didn't explain himself properly here, and you don't have to look too far to hear that he just doesn't really understand. Sexual harassment cannot be conflated with crowding someone's personal space, and that's the way a lot of people heard what he said. And the good thing, the way that norms have changed, is that we have created, thanks to the Me Too movement, an environment for women to be able to come out and not fear losing their job, not fear being persecuted, not fear being looked down upon because they are explaining, look, my boss or the President of the United States or a U.S. senator sexually harassed me. And fortunately, the norms now are creating an environment where women can come forward and do have the courage. And fortunately, they have other women that have blazed the trail and enabled them to come forward. And unfortunately, former President CLlNTON is doing is he's stepping in it once again. You know, just the other day, he says he doesn't owe Monica Lewinsky an apology, and he does. He owes
he
her
did not
a personal
say that.
Apology, and he owes a lot of women personal
excuse
apologies.
Excuse me, I agreed with everything you said until you misspoke yourself. He said he publicly apologized to the American people, to Monica Lewinsky and her family.
Lanny, let's listen to it, and then I'll let you finish. Go on. Here okay. It is.
I felt terrible then, and I came to grips with it.
Did you ever apologize to her?
No, yes.
But you didn't apologize to her.
I have not talked to her.
Do you feel like you owe her an apology?
No, I do. I do not. I've never talked to her. But I did say publicly on more than one occasion that I was sorry.
Go ahead, Lanny.
You clipped it. The next sentence was, I said I was sorry to my, to the American people. Nothing funny here. Sorry.
I'm sorry.
He said the next sentence right after that sentence was, I apologize to the American people. I apologize to Monica Lewinsky and her family publicly, and I apologize to my family. And as to whether he picked up the phone personally and called, I don't think that that would have been appropriate, but he did exactly say what I said.
Good, Angela.
Lanny, so look, I've known you for a long time, and I know you worked, Lanny, I know you worked really, really hard to defend your friend Bill Clinton. But the fact of the matter is, if he has not picked up the phone and he hasn't reached out to her personally, he has not issued a personal apology to Monica Lewinsky. Saying it to the public and saying it out and open is one thing, but personally apologizing to someone who you did something like this to, it's important to issue that apology, and I think he should do it. And I think it's important for all of America to understand that he took the internal fortitude to make that apology. And I'm sorry, Angela.
No, that's okay. Before I get to the break, I want to hear from Angela. Go ahead, Angela.
So really quick, Lanny, I did laugh because Bill Clinton, again, was struggling. So he says, no, yes, yes, no. I mean, it's like you can piece together the narrative that you want. But the reality of it is he did not issue a direct apology to Monica Lewinsky. I do not think he should be dialing her 7 or 10 digits. I don't think he should. Like, I don't think that would be smart on his part.
Look, but I respect.
But I do, think
that it's very important to understand there's another issue here. It is the elephant in the room. Whoever is responsible for the PR surrounding Bill Clinton and Stephen King's book needs to get it together. These questions are going to come.
Chase
they don't
Patterson.
Care enough about the book. They want to know
quick,
about what
quick
happened.
Response. Just thank you, and I'm sorry to interrupt you. Yeah. I respect your opinion.
Hey, Lanny,
about
can you hold that to the other side of the break? Let me just get to the break here, and then I'll come back.
Leave it as I respect your opinion, and then we'll break.
We'll be right
back. Thank you, Lanny.